the faith of Abel and Enoch. We're looking at Hebrews 11, which is called as the Hall of Faith, and it talks about the lives of many men and women who had faith in God and fulfilled the purpose of their lives. And today we're going to look at Abel and Enoch specifically. In verse 4, we read about Abel. By faith, Abel offered to God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain, through which he obtained witness that he was righteous, God testifying of his gifts, and through it, he being dead still speaks. Let's first look at the life of Abel and the fact that God was pleased with Abel's sacrifice. Was it because Abel gave God meat and Cain gave God vegetables? Not really. The difference was not the kind of sacrifice which was brought to God, but the difference was the faith behind the sacrifice. The same thing applies to us in our lives. We do so many things. We bring offerings to God, all kinds of offerings. But what God is looking at, God is looking beyond the offering. God is looking beyond the type of offering. God is looking beyond the size of the offering. God is looking at the faith in the offering. And in this case, Abel's sacrifice or Abel's offering had faith, but Cain's did not, which is what put God off. And Abel's sacrifice was received by God while Cain's was left out. Abel's sacrifice is also seen here as righteous by God. And what makes it righteous? Faith. Faith makes our sacrifice righteous. And as we continue to notice the life of Abel and what pleased God about Abel, we also see that God testifies of Abel's, God testifies of his gifts, and through it, he being dead still speaks. Now, this tells us that even when we are dead and gone, our sacrifices are before the Lord, and the sacrifices made by faith are before the Lord. So whatever it is we do for God, speak even after we are gone. So how do we leave behind a legacy? Do things by faith. When we do our work, when we live our life by faith, it lives on beyond our lifetime. God receives it, that is one thing, but our offering of faith lives on to glorify God. Our works of faith live on to glorify God, and that's the confidence we have. In verse 5 talks about the faith of Enoch. Verse 5 says, by faith Enoch was taken away so that he did not see death and was not found because God had taken him. For before he was taken, he had this testimony that he pleased God. Now here's an incredible testimony that a man did not face death. But how was this possible? He did it by faith, right? And Enoch's life of faith pleased God so much that it was God's decision that he would take Enoch, as it is, without him having to face death. So looking at the lives of both Abel and Enoch, there's one thing that's very, very clear. God is pleased by the faith in our hearts. And so let's live this life by faith. Let's walk by faith. Let's do all things by faith. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we thank you, God, that Lord, we are filled with faith, Lord, through your word. And God, I just pray that each one of us, Father God, will walk in faith in all that is before us, Lord, this day. Lord, I pray that, Lord, we will do nothing, Lord, as a work of the flesh, Lord. We'll do nothing, Lord, with just our selfish ambition in mind, but Lord, that we will have faith in you. Lord, we will have faith in the fact that, Lord, you are real and that you are a rewarder when we do things, Father God, diligently for you, and we honor you. We thank you, God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.